autopsy victims, gutted like a catfish whose fate has been sealed by cornmeal and hot cooking oil. Did not like what he saw. A body raw with guilt and defiance, white lies and half truths, low down Howlin' Wolf and Robert Johnson blues, and repressed Jill Scott and Barry White laden sex fantasies, picked clean from the inside out. Under the stars in a four-door sedan, I caught myself not being man enough to own it, though I'm not the only one to blame. The bottom line is that shame is a dish you don't want to share with loved ones, cause everyone winds up getting sick, just like I did all the way down to my mere existence of flesh and bones, propelled only by my unwillingness to die an early death. Does love not live here anymore? This buzzing between my ears, which is only sounds like noise and distortion to my living autopsy existence. For heartbreak had disintegrated the muscle and marrow that chimed and resonated with even the most unsavory of notes. It remains a mystery to me how my flesh and bones have remained afloat in the undertow of such a void. Such a void. This heart is no toy to play with. I can barely keep a grip on this delicate muscle. But even if these mere flesh and bones that tear and break are all I have to work with to hold on to this heart, worth the fight. Does love not live here?